All right, guys, apparently we are recording. Volume seems to be working. I decided to use a different program. I've been using QuickTime to record my screen, but I've recently acquired another app, a couple apps actually I'm going to start with. One of them is Snagit, and that is a program that I got off stacksocial.com through the Mac Bundle 4.0, which I'm sure... I think by now the sale has ended on that, but I got that as a bundle of a bunch of different apps. And but today we're going to talk about the topic of the Pomodoro Technique. And I mentioned this in a vlog a couple videos back or so, that I've been experimenting with this. And I have, and I'm actually writing down some of the things that I've been doing today, and it's keeping me on track. Like I said before, it's you have to stick with it, because even today I found myself not taking regular breaks, and I've got to watch myself on that. So it may not be something that would be useful in the long term, but I am going to continue to try to work on it. So without further ado, let's get on into the Pomodoro Technique and show you this cool Chrome theme that I installed. I love this line theme here. It's pretty cool. Okay, so I'm going to take you to some of the bookmarks that I have bookmarked for this specific technique. And as you can see, I have tons of bookmarks here. I organize my bookmarks in folders, and there are tons upon tons upon tons of business bookmarks alone. Okay, may have to do a screencast on some of those things. But for now, we're going to go to entrepreneurial, productivity, lifestyle hacks, and I'm going to show you a couple different things here. The first thing is going to be how to create more margin in your life. Now, if you haven't went to look at this, I have this on one of my vlogs, and you need to go check that out. So let's open another one up here, and we're going to go to how to use batching. That's going to be the next one, and I wish Chrome would quit, you know, stopping these, but it's what it's doing here. And then let's do one more here. Maybe two more. Depends on what I've got here. Okay. All right. Now, let's see here. Think that's about right. Okay, so we have a couple things here. Here's where I first learned about the Pomodoro Technique. Okay, we're going to go to Michael Hyatt's blog, michaelhyatt.com/more-margin. Like I said, these links are on my most recent Guitarpreneur vlog, or should be. They're on one or two of them, talking about, you know, being a guitarpreneur in 2014, and I think it's on that one. Specifically, these links are in that post. I may try to add them to this one as well. But this is the post that I first got that I started listening to Michael Hyatt. I actually found him on a podcast that he was being interviewed by Cliff Ravenscraft, a podcast answer man. As well, he was on Ray Edwards' podcast. But both of them talked about this one right here, I think. How to create more margin in your life. And basically, you can read this when you get to it, but it's basically talking about how to use the space in your life and organize it better. And it took me to the My Ideal Week. Now, I have an actual, I've got an actual link to this post in that blog, becoming a guitarpreneur in 2014 on my YouTube site. The link is there, and I think, if I'm not mistaken, it's www.secretsoftexasbluesguitar.com/guitarpreneur-2014. So if I was to take that and put that right here in this tab, let's see. Secrets of Texas Blues Guitar slash, here it is, Guitarpreneur 2014. It takes you right to some of these things that I'm mentioning here, but my version of them. So you'll see my version of My Ideal Week. I actually got my template from Michael Hyatt here on this right here website. And then mine, I just copied that and made my own arrangement of that. And that is going to show up here in just a second. Now, I think it's running a little slower because I'm screen recording right now. So, but anyway, as while we're waiting for that, let's go ahead and continue to use this and scroll down here. There we go. Let's see here. My Ideal Week spreadsheet talks about scheduling your life. Talks about here's what I suggest. Okay. Now we're going to get on to some of the Pomodoro technique things. But anyway, here's that article that I did for Becoming a Guitarpreneur in 2014. And if you go to this website right up here, this will take you to this page where you can check this out. This is the video series that I refer to, which does contain Guitarpreneur 2014. Now, you notice I put my own version of this right here. You can click it, and it will take you to a download page where you can download this and create your own as either an OpenOffice spreadsheet or an Excel spreadsheet. They're both the same thing. It's just the different formats, okay? So you can – here's his version of that, and then I went to my website and put my version up based on his, using kind of the same color scheme and things like that. Okay, he says – the things that you can do is create a template. That's what I was just talking about. Next thing is to identify your themes, and that refers to, you know, these right here. Is this about to do with self, work, or family time, planning, friends, things like that? I'm not going to get into the details of that, but what we're getting into now is this batch similar activities together. Now, I want you to notice that. This is the one that I just opened up right up here. Okay, now this has to do with the Pomodoro technique, what he mentions. So I'm kind of showing you the chain of events of how I got to the Pomodoro technique. First, it came through looking at more margin here. And then I scroll down and click these links that he mentions, these things that has to do with this Ideal Week, which one of them is batch similar activities. And when I click that, it pulls this up. How to use batching to become more productive, okay? So we have that. So I begin to watch this, and all of a sudden this big tomato jumps at me, okay? And you see it right here. And this is, talks about the Pomodoro technique. Right here you see that, okay? It takes you to the website, which I will get to here in just a second. It talks about batching, which is simply a form of time management that allows a person to maximize concentration and decrease distraction. And this is still a work in progress. I'm going on about 3 weeks to a month doing this, and it's still a work in progress. I did really good the first day on writing down my distractions, but I haven't been doing it since. That's one thing I've got to focus on, is not letting those things get to me. But if you read this article, it's very interesting what it tells you about. So it tells you about, basically, here's the Pomodoro technique in a nutshell. It's one method for batching tasks. Here's how it works. Number one, plan and prioritize the tasks that need to be completed by writing them down. And there's some sheets that I'll give to you here in just a second that are also listed on this article. Here's some other things that I've got going on, my goals and all this stuff. There's going to be another article post I'm going to do just on the Pomodoro technique, and that article post is where the sheets for the Pomodoro technique will be listed. So I'll just go ahead and show you those here in just a second. But anyway, you write them down, print these sheets off, you write them down. This is separate from your daily planner, okay? Your daily planner, your weekly planner, whatever, you write the task for that day on the Pomodoro technique sheet, and then you start, you know, batching them out there and working on them. And there was some way that I had heard that you can use Snagit to record a webcam as well. I'm not sure if it's going to allow me to do that, but I don't want to spend a long time trying to figure it out. I'll have to actually look that up. That way you can see, because I use a lot of hand gestures. So obviously it's hard to you to see what I'm doing. If you can't see the video here. So I actually need to find out about using the webcam. so that you can see that. But that'll just have to be for another one, I'm guessing, because it says there should be a way to do that. And I'm not seeing how to do that, so I'll just have to look that up. Connect mobile device. I don't think it'd be in there. There should be like a webcam capture thing here somewhere, but I guess not. Yeah. So I'll just have to wait on that. But anyway, I'll research that for the next time. So here we go. You write those down, and then you set a timer for about 25 minutes. Now, the Pomodoro technique, if you've heard me mention this, Pomodoro is Italian for tomato, apparently. That's the where you get this. And the guy that invented this basically bought a kitchen timer that looked like a tomato and started doing this and really liked it and developed this technique. And he couldn't think of a name for it, so he decided to name it after this little tomato timer. So that's where Pomodoro comes from. In fact, if I search for that, you can see where the actual name came from here. About the name, here we go. What about the name? Pomodoro means tomato in Italian. The inventor of the technique, Francesco Cirillo, Italian, initially used a tomato-shaped kitchen timer when he developed the technique. So, number one, plan and prioritize. That's key. Prioritize. That is key, okay? Then you set a timer for 25 minutes. That's key as well. Devote that time to a task or a group of similar tasks. Larger tasks can be broken up into multiple blocks or Pomodoros. And smaller tasks, like responding to email, returning phone calls, can be grouped into a single block. Now, let's see here. There we go. I can zoom in a little bit using my Mac. Let's do that. Okay, after completing each Pomodoro, you put an X next to it on that paper and mark the number of times that you were distracted. Now, I haven't been doing this. I've actually been doing marking down the estimated time that it would take me, the actual time it would take me, and the difference. As far as the number of times distracted, I don't mess with it. And if it's completed, I don't put an X by it. I just move on to the next task. Because if I'm writing down that it's been completed, and here's the real time that it's been completed, then I know it's done. So, but I might start putting an X next to things. I don't know. We'll find out. Anyway, take a five-minute break. Okay, number three is important. Take a five-minute break. Because the idea of the Pomodoro is so that you do not get burnt out. You do not want to get burnt out when you're doing your daily tasks. Trust me. It's very easy to do. It's very easy to get overwhelmed. You've got your calendar set up and you want to get things done. But more often than not, if you're anything like me, you have your you have your calendar stacked on top of each other. Events after events after events, more than likely. So, problem with that is you get burnt out really easy, all right? Okay, so you get burnt out very easy, and what you need to do is take your five-minute breaks. This is part of the technique. This is basically what you might call the protocol. Then you go ahead and begin another block of time, or Pomodoro. Now, this says larger tasks can be broken into multiple blocks. So I'm not sure if it's saying do four Pomodoros, then take a five-minute break, or if it's saying after each 125 minutes, take a break. I'm pretty sure it's saying after 25 minutes, take a break. You've earned a break. You have spent 25 minutes working on a task, okay? It's time for break. The next thing, you begin another block or Pomodoro, and then after completing four, you take an extended break, 20-minute break, okay? Now, I haven't been doing this because usually that runs right into my lunch. After four Pomodoros, it's usually about lunchtime for me, especially with, you know, a break. So if I zoom out here and go to my calculator, that's roughly about four Pomodoros is 2 hours. And if I start the day a little later, that runs into a lunch or usually when I'm ready for lunch. It usually just works like that. So 25 plus a five-minute break, okay, times four equals 120 divided by 60, because there's 60 minutes in an hour. You got 2 hours, okay? So after that 2 hours, if you've taken a five-minute break, take an extended 20-minute break. Now, the math doesn't really add up to that, okay? And here's why. 25 plus a 5 minute break, okay? All right, so that is one Pomodoro. Then plus another 25, plus another 5 minute break. Then plus another 25, plus a 5 minute break. Then plus another 25, which is the fourth Pomodoro. So you have to take 20 minutes. So that's 45. Okay. Now, I think that's the fourth Pomodoro. Let's just make sure and do this one more time. 25 plus 25 plus 25 plus four Pomodoros. Okay, after the first one, you take 1 5-minute break. The second one, you take another 5-minute break. The third one, you take another 5-minute break. And after four Pomodoros, you take a 20-minute break, which gives you 135. Divide that by 60. That takes you about 2 hours and 25 minutes. Or 2 hours. No, that's 2.25, so that's about 2 hours and 15 minutes. Okay? So, you know, without being too mathy there, that's basically in a nutshell. It's going to take you a little over 2 hours. Okay, so that's basically it. Okay, now there's probably other things to this, but the sheets will kind of guide you along in this. And I'll get to the Pomodoro website here in a second, actually. It says, according to them, you'll see noticeable improvements in your productivity almost immediately and mastery of the technique in 7 to 20 days. Now, I'm not mastered this technique, and it's been about 3 weeks, so that's over 20 days. But it seems like to me it's got to be a habit. You've got to keep going at it until it becomes set and that you can do it, complete it. You know, a habit's got to be, you know, 21 to 30 days, it'll become a habit. And I've fallen off the wagon a couple times, so every time you do that, you have to start all over and work at it. So eventually I'll get there, but you just got to work at it. Okay, so the resources, all right? So we'll get to these resources here in a second. But when you click the Pomodoro website, it takes you straight to PomodoroTechnique.com, which their default page is Get Started. See, if I just went to PomodoroTechnique.com, it would take me to actually, it's not defaulted to Get Started. That's what my bookmark was set at, because that's what I wanted it to be. So here's this little video here. It's only a 2-minute video. Let's go ahead and listen to it and watch it and see what's going on.
Is a Pomodoro. This is a Pomodoro timer. This is the Pomodoro technique. The Pomodoro technique is a simple yet very effective way to improve your work and study habits. The basic requirement of this technique is to set the kitchen timer to 25 minutes. But this is just the beginning. In order to become a certified Pomodoro master, you need to achieve the following 6 objectives. First, find out how much effort an activity requires you by monitoring how many Pomodoros you need in order to accomplish a specific task. Second, learn to protect your Pomodoro from the internal and external interruptions. Third, make accurate estimations of how many Pomodoros you need for a certain activity. Fourth, use your Pomodoro time not just to work on your task, but spend a few minutes for recap and the last ones for review. Fifth, set a timetable according to your to-dos, to your time, or even to the season. This is good for organizing work and also for creating more free time. Sixth, once you have completed these objectives, find your own personal objective, such as being more efficient or improving the quality of your work. For example, a writer could track more accurately what he's doing during a Pomodoro, or a team may want to find out how good its cooperation is. But remember, you have to choose your own final objective. In order to achieve the best results, the objectives should be done incrementally. In other words, if you didn't complete an objective, don't move ahead to the next one. Continue trying to do better with the current objective until you feel that you've mastered it. For more in-depth tips, read the original book, record your progress, and become a certified Pomodoro master. PomodoroTechnique.com. I love my time.
All right.
2 hours and 43 minutes were saved using the Pomodoro technique in the making of this video.
That's interesting. Didn't see that before. Anyway, there you go. That's what it looks like. And let me let it finish so it'll... There you go.
This?
There we go. All right, so you see it's a lot more involved than what I'm telling you. But the basics to get started are right here on the batching. That's the link. And like I said, I'll probably leave a link of this in the bottom of the video. This is the basics right here. All right? So it takes you to this website. You can see all kinds of cool stuff. You can see Get Started. You can buy the book. You can buy the timer itself. You can take a course. If you go to Get Started, it kind of tells you how to get started, obviously. So here's some questions. Why Pomodoro? It's not like any other time management method on the market today. What makes it so unique? You work with time, not against it. You eliminate burnout because of the taking short scheduled breaks instead of running on fumes. You manage your distractions. Notice that they are separated with this red line. And right now, it's still hard to do that. You know, if you're looking at your screen or whatever during work on a computer like I do, then it's going to be hard to eliminate things that are, you know, catching your eye. What you could do is open a new tab and separate it from what you're working on in Chrome or Firefox or whatever. And that will help you manage that. Another thing to do that's really helpful for me is turning off your push notifications. Turn them things off. You don't need Google Plus or Facebook or Twitter or Gmail, you know, notifying you every 15 seconds, hey, somebody needs your attention. No, your projects need your attention. Your goals need your attention. Those things need your attention, okay? So it manages distractions, okay? And they can wait. If you write them down, you can get to them later. It's not like you're going to have them in your head and say, oh, I can't forget this. Write it down. You won't forget it. You won't have to worry about it. And it talks about creating a better work-life balance. Now, you can go to who. Who's it for? It's for writers. It's for lawyers. It's for developers. You know, it's for directors. It's for students. It's for teachers. It's for managers. It's for anybody. I mean, you know, some of these examples you can find here. Draft a book in 3 weeks. And if you click on that, I never saw this before. If you click on that, it'll take you to this post. How the Pomodoro Technique can help you draft your book in just 3 weeks while still having a life. Okay, so that's pretty cool. There may be some other stuff here as far as... Scroller keeps messing up on me. Do-do-do-do-do. There we go. Come on. Structure classroom time. So, you know, you can click on that and see what it says. Teach kids how to do a Pomodoro cleaning, you know. So, they've got some cool little ideas here. And here's that thing. How can I help you draft your book in 3 weeks? In just 25 minutes a day. How it works. How I drafted my book. Make it work for you. So that's pretty cool. You can find that by going to the Pomodoro Technique, clicking on Get Started, and then clicking on Who, and then there it is, right there. And the other thing, how do you do it? Just like the post said, you choose a task you'd like to get done. Write it down, okay? What matters is that it's something that deserves your full, undivided attention. The next thing, set the Pomodoro or timer for 25 minutes. Now, I use something called a countdown timer for my Droid app, my Droid phone. I just use this phone for, you know, apps and getting on the internet when I need to. I don't use it for calls or anything like that. I've got a little paper, prepaid is what I'm trying to say, prepaid phone for that. But I've got this app on my phone called Countdown Timer that I use. And I set it for 25 minutes, and then when it goes off, I set when it rings. If I realize I got something else I need to do. Now, here's the key. If you realize you have something else you need to do, write it down on a sheet of paper. I've got a pad over here right next to me, just a small legal type pad called Pomodoro Technique Distractions. That's what I wrote on the top page. And, you know, I'll keep those done. Then later, during one of those 5-minute breaks, I can get one of those distractions done, or I can actually take a break and not do something work-related and get back to that on some of that time that is saved down the road using my ideal week on this schedule. Now, the gray areas here you'll notice are for margin. So anytime during that I can maybe use to fix those distractions, you know. Okay, so let's get back here. When it's done, put a check mark on the paper, take a short break, go grab a cup of coffee, breathe, you know, read, do something, go for a short walk, and your brain will thank you later, okay? So, yeah, it's very important to do those things. If possible, get out of the office completely, go walk around the living room, go do some other things, and that'll be a lot better. Now, every 4 Pomodoros, you take a longer break. Once you complete, you can take a longer, 20 minutes is good, or 30. Your brain will use the time to assimilate new information and rest before the next round of Pomodoros. That's very important there, okay? Okay, so the next thing, benefits. You can find out how much effort an activity requires. Recently, I did a vlog on how much some things required. And see, this is the being a guitarpreneur in 2014. Recently, I did a vlog on my YouTube page that has to do with time management, okay? And it was a really recent vlog, so you can check that out. And it talked about what I found out when I was doing all these things. Okay, matter of fact, let me go over here and bring it up, and then I can show it to you guys. I'm on my other monitor here, so give me just a second. Like I said, it's going a little slow because of the screen capture. Right now we're at 27 minutes. This video is going to be uploaded straight to YouTube. I'm not going to worry about editing this, so if you have problems with the pauses, just skip ahead because I do have a busy day today, and I'm more focused on some other things that I've got to get done. So let me go up here to my video manager in YouTube. And we'll see what the name of this, or what the link is to this, so that you can find it. I may not list this as a link below. Mainly I'm just going to be working with stuff on Pomodoro Technique, so I may forget that. If I do, at least now you'll have it. You can go check it out. All right. Okay, should be right here. Yeah. You can just go to my YouTube page and look for Guitarpreneur Hangout, New Effects Pedal, Time Management, and something called Spigma, okay? So this talks about, in time management, it talks about what I found regarding the different things on Texas Blues guitar. And let's see if it's going to show. There we go. For some examples here.
The sheet. And write down what you do, what you need to do for today only, okay? Then you sit down and you write down how many Pomodoros
you put. Okay, so you see what I'm doing there. I'm kind of describing it, and I wanted to do a screencast of this as well. That's a terrible picture to leave. I'm just scratching my nose there. But you see, I've got the papers in hand that I'm using to do all these Pomodoro techniques, and I wanted to show you visually the process, and I want to show you the results that I found as far as, you know, how long it would take me to do these tasks. I by no means have found the best way to do it. You know, later on, if I really get into this, I may decide to buy the book and then find out what happens. But if you go to my YouTube channel and go to Eric Beatty, click on that, and then go to the Guitarpreneur Hangout that says New Effects Pedal, Time Management, and SPBGMA. Okay? All right. So let's get off that, and we'll go back to how it will change you. There you go. Count down on interruptions. Cut down on interruptions. You don't have to worry about that. You can be able to stay focused, which is key if you want to get anything done. You must focus, all right? You've heard me mention that many times. Estimate the effort for activities. It'll allow you to be able to find out how long it's going to take you to get something done so that you can actually plan accordingly and plan more accurately, okay? So say you got to check your email. Well, I know it's going to take me one palm or about 30 minutes, 25 minutes to do that. I'll plan for that. Maybe it'll only take half of that. Maybe it'll take half of a palm. So I'll plan for that, about 15 minutes or something like that. And it'll allow you to schedule your time during the day. But also, don't forget, don't stack your events like that. You know, after that, you got to remember that you have to allow for breaks. So if something's going to take you a palm, allow for a 30-minute, because you got to allow for the 25 minutes, then the 5-minute break. So set it up to be 30 minutes if it's going to take one palm. If it's going to take two palms, then you're going to have 2 5-minute breaks. Okay, so, and then 2 25-minute intervals. So set your activity for an hour. That will include the time. That's really interesting how that does that. Okay, so it also makes the Pomodoro more effective. What you do within the Pomodoros can be adjusted to maximize efficiency. One way to make a Pomodoro more effective is to use the first few minutes to review what you've done before. Other methods are discussed in the book. Okay, I just mentioned that in the thing. You can set up a timetable. It sets a limit, motivating you to complete a task within a set period of time. It also delineates your work from time. Your work time from your free time. Creating a clear timetable will allow you to enjoy your time off without worrying what you could be doing, that you could be doing more work. Define your own objectives. The Pomodoro Technique is a tool you can use to reach your own objectives. For example, a writer might realize he's spending much time revising and adjust his Pomodoro timetable to allow for more brainstorming time. Now, I have found that it does allow you to enjoy your time off without having to worry about you could be doing more work. And that is because you actually feel like you're getting things done, and you are getting things done. It is working. I found when I started doing that, it was a lot easier to get out of the workspace, out of my office every day at around 5 or 6 or whenever the workday was completed, and not feel I have to come back in here to get things done that I didn't complete before. Only reason I would come back in here is because I wanted to. I wanted to work on something else, or I wanted to work on a side project, you know, that I enjoy doing, like editing some of my videos, things like that. So, yes, it does give you a sense of gratitude, not gratitude, but a sense of, you know, accomplishment. All right, so, and then the last thing, it says get to work. So here's your different things that you can buy, all right? So it says track progress. So here's where we're going to find the different sheets, all right, that are mentioned. And what I'll do is I'll go back and then actually show you where they are on this thing here. The Pomodoro Technique one-page technique cheat sheet. Now, some of these links don't work. Like a free PDF of the Pomodoro Technique book, that doesn't work. I don't know if it's just they just didn't allow that anymore, or if this is a bad link. But you got a to-do checklist, you got activity inventory. I'm pretty sure that both of these work. And the technique cheat sheet, I don't think it works. Okay, seems like there's a bad link on that. Page not found. Yeah, so that one doesn't work. Pomodoro app, you can actually get the app. You can actually, if you want to, also download apps for Chrome. There's actually one, something called a Chromodoro, but some people haven't, you know, really enjoyed that one. Just look at the reviews and find some timers. I've got one on my other tab here that I'll bring over here called Online Timer. It's from timeanddate.com/timer, and they have their own timers, and I've already actually set up my Pomodoro Technique. The only bad thing about this is once it goes off, you kind of tend to ignore it because it's not a physical timer on your desk. It's another part of your whole workspace here, so you tend to ignore that. So I just got into doing some of these other things. So I've got a timer for my 5 minutes, so they'll go off and I don't go over that. I got a timer for my 20-minute break, so when it goes off, you know, don't have to worry about that. Okay, so basically, and if you have questions about the other thing, I'll get to that in just a second, the 48-12 and all that. I'll get to that in just a second. So let's look at some of these sheets here. If you go to Get Started, and go to Get to Work, then you'll find here's the things that you can get to work. So let's just do an open link in new tab. Now this is one of the links. Open the link in the new tab for this one. Let me make sure it's going to work here. To do today, inventory. And then this last one is, I'm looking at the links down here that's popping up, by the way. This one says records. Okay, so there's a couple different things. So we've opened that link in a new tab, apparently, yeah. So that's the second one. First one is, if it will show up, to do and then inventory. So we got to find our to do. That one says to do. Move it over. And then inventory should be next. And it's that one. And then the last one should be records. Okay, so your to do task. This is what you get when you click this. It's right here. To do today. And this is the only page that I use. This is the only page that I use, okay? When you get here, you can download this. Just go over here and click save, and it will download it. And I've got one of these saved so that I can print it whenever I need to. It says here on the bottom, anything that comes up that's urgent and unplanned, right from the bottom up, so that you can always get your priorities done first, and then come down here and work your way up, okay? This is the only one I use because, as you'll see here in just a second, the activity inventory, I don't understand. They look the same. I mean, there's the exact same thing. I don't know why you have to, unless this is, you're going to list your activities that you need to get done, and then you transfer them over to your to-do today. I'm guessing that's what it is. Here's all your activities you need to get done this week if you don't have a planner. If you do have a planner, just look in your planner. You don't need this extra sheet. And the last thing is records. Now, what I did was I actually took this idea of your estimate time and then your real time and your difference. I actually decided to put it on this sheet. So I just sit every time and I'll put up here somewhere estimated, real, and difference, and then I'll start doing it according to that. Because the only thing I really need is the date. Usually I put the date here on the margin, and then I'll put the activity, or not the activity, but the type of activity. If it's going to be administrative, like checking emails, administrative. If it's going to be YouTube videos, then that's the activity here, and then right here is going to be videos. If it's going to be practice guitar, right here it's going to be play, guitar. Whatever you want to call that. So I took basically the ideas of this sheet so that it wouldn't be so, you know, a ton of this stuff. Now some of my activities can get long, so I'd rather have this space here for that activity. And so I took some of these things and transferred them over to that. So you can write your date. The time doesn't really, you know, doesn't really matter. Estimates how many Pomodoros. One is, I just use hash marks, but I'm thinking about going over to actual numbers because it's getting to be a lot of hash marks to keep up with. Then you get your real time, and then how long did it actually take you was this, and then you have your difference. So this kind of helps you gauge how long a task or how short a task is going to be. Okay. And once again, you can go and get these by going to pomodorotechnique.com, get started right here, and then get to work. And you can download those three sheets. And that's the same sheets that's over here on Michael Hyatt's How to Use Batching to Become More Productive link, okay? These links I will post on the bottom here. And if I forget one, you at least have, you know, the links here so that you can go check them out. Okay, so let's see. I think that's pretty much it for that. The only other thing that I was going to list, and once again, this is if you don't have a planner, this is great. You can list all your activities here. If you do have a planner, like I do, then just take your planner activities and put them in here, what you're going to do today. Now, what I do is I'll have four or five tasks, maybe six or seven, and at the end of the day, I'll just leave it blank. I'm not going to print out a sheet for every day. I'll just leave it blank. The next day, I'll skip a line and then write the new date here in the margin and begin from there, okay? The other thing is, I don't print this out when the first page is done. I flip it over and continue to do the same thing on the back. All you got to do is write 1, 2, 3, and then four or five lines on the back, and you don't have to draw them all the way down. You can just do the blocks up here like this, and then you're done. Okay, so those are the three sheets there. And the other thing I was going to show you, if you didn't notice it before, was on this online timer. You can see a 48:12 right here and a 12 minute break. Now this is an idea that I found over here on this guy's website, and this is a guy that actually works with Michael Hyatt, or did work with him, and somehow I think I found him on Michael Hyatt somewhere in one of these sites. So if I type in 48, it's not going to show anything there. I'm not going to show anything there. Somehow I learned about him through Michael Hyatt, though. I think actually might have been on one of the guy's comments. I think his name's John. So let's find a John here. Nope, it's not that dude. Richardson, John Richardson. Let's go over here and look for that guy. Oh, apparently not there. Yeah, that's how you spell his name, so let's find him over here. Bingo. I found a similar... Okay, here it is. Here's where I found it. It's on the how to create more margin in your life, okay? You go down to the bottom where he talks about his ideal week and all that. Let's see. Talks about using the same idea. And then what I did, I think, having the privilege of being on your book launch team, I was amazed at how much time and effort the book success launch takes. So yeah, he was on the launch team for Michael Hyatt's platform book, if I'm not mistaken. Now the other thing was, I actually went to his site, and that's when I heard about and when I found the 48-minute Empower Hour. And you can find this by going to personalsuccesstoday.com/the 48-minute Empower Hour. Okay. Once again, this link will be on the bottom here in the YouTube, if I don't forget it. So basically, this idea was the power of 48 minutes. And if you look at the bottom down here, when I hover over this, it says strong goals, timing is everything. So you can click on that and see what that's about. I'm not going to do that right now. We're already 40 minutes into the video, 42 minutes. Okay, so we're going to wrap this thing up. The idea is, instead of working, let me just go ahead and read. I have written exclusively over the years about the power of 48 minutes. Simply, this is a way to divide an hour into 80-20. The way the program works is to block out all distractions and do one task for 48 minutes and then take a 12-minute break. Repeat as necessary. The beauty of it is its simplicity. This is the same idea as, you know, the Pomodoro Technique, except instead of smaller increments, I've been, you know, trying to use this instead of Pomodoros for bigger tasks. Like if I want to spend an hour and a half on something, or if I want to spend an hour on something, I guess. You do it in 48 minutes and you just push through it. You don't let any distractions hit you or hinder you. You push through it until it's done, or until the 48-minute timer goes off. And when it does, if the task is still not done, then you can revert if it's going to take you another hour if you want to do it. Or if it's not, if you know it's going to take a few minutes, then what you do is you take and begin the Pomodoro Technique from then. Okay? So that's what happens there. Using this single tasking idea, and that's important, it's a single task thing. You don't want to multitask. There's actually another article that I need to read myself that I have enabled on another thing here called, you know, how to limit why multitasking is terrible for you. Single tasking ideas helped me accomplish many large projects over the years, such as writing a book, training for a triathlon, getting my workday under control. The key to making it work is preparation. I need to clear my area of distractions, okay? That's what he says right here. Clear my area of distractions by turning off email, phone, any browsers I may have open. Then you set the timer for 48 minutes and begin. The really cool thing about the 48-minute period is that it can be divided into many different ways, okay? Now we get back into the idea of, you know, Pomodoros. You can do two projects in that time at 24 minutes each. You can do three projects at 16 minutes each, four projects at 12 minutes each, and eight projects at 6 minutes, Okay, so you can divide it out. And here is his little little handout things that he has. Okay, so if I'll just open these in a new tab, and then we'll get to those here in just a second. To make the division easier to plan, I've come up with some simple planning sheets marked by that time. So these are the divisions, basically. I find that getting a lot of smaller things accomplished by using the sheets to plan ahead, you can get a lot more small things done. The real problem with single tasking strategies is the break time. If you reintroduce distractions, you will often not be able to continue. 48-minute works well since it's based around the common hour and gives you time to stretch, use the restroom, and fill up your coffee. Okay? Fill up your coffee. If you don't have an hour, you can use the sheets for shorter periods of time. If you're familiar with doing other single tasking strategies such as the Pomodoro, bingo, here we got Michael Hyatt's blog again. You may find these sheets helpful in dividing up your time in strategic ways. Here's a custom sheet I did for a web project this week. That's this one right here. I divided my 48-minute time period into 4 different projects. Using the sheet allowed me to allocate individual time periods without using too much time on any one item. It really works well when you have an hour and you can get multiple things done. So you're kind of multitasking, but you're not. You get multiple things done, but you're single-tasking each one of those. Okay? Get to the end of the time your period, you need to move to the next item. Really helps with procrastination or opening the projects. Here's a short video showing the procedure. And it is very short. Let's watch it real quick. It's only 46 minutes long. Hang in there with me, guys. Just about done. Okay, obviously edited in iMovie. Of the great Arnold Schwarzenegger, do it now. Okay, so there's my little impression for you for today. All right, so do one thing. This goes back to something that's also on this Guitarpreneur vlog here. One of my focus goals right here. Focus is follow one course until successful. I got that from Donald Trump and Robert Kiyosaki's book, The Midas Touch. And I have memorized that little puppy, and it's very, very helpful to focus on one thing until, at least in this case, the task is done and you can move on to another task. Or if you're doing, you know, a huge project, focus on it when it's time to focus on it and don't let anything else distract you, okay? So basically, that's it for today. Over here is the sheets that he has done. Apparently, it's the same thing every time. Okay, so these are just some sheets that he's done, which for some reason you can't print them out. I guess this is just a JPEG, I reckon. So, I don't know why you can't print them out, but anyway, you get the idea. Divide it up, divide and conquer. Divide your time up and conquer. Okay, so, pretty sure that was it. But he said, like, one of the key things he said was, the key to making it work is preparation. You have to get ready. Notice it said, when it said get ready on this video, the guy was pouring a cup of coffee or tea or whatever. Make your workspace ready for you to work. Make it comfortable. Prepare to work. And then, you know, prepare it once for the rest of the day. That way you don't have to fool with it every 45 minutes or so, every, you know, Pomodoro. But I think that's all I was going to list on this. Let me go to my calendar real quick and make sure that I'm not forgetting anything. Yes, I think I got it all. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. I'm going to get off here, and hopefully this thing ain't going to be saved in a huge file. Once again, do check out, and I'll go ahead and recommend them because I got this for an awesome price. wrong. Stack Social, not Strack Social. Go check out Stack Social. They've got all kinds of bundles, all kinds of applications that you can use. What you do is you name your own price, and if you beat the average price, you get all the apps in the bundle. Okay, that's the way it works. So that's what I did. I beat the average price. I named my own price, and I got all of my I got all of my apps for that price, and here it is. 10% goes to charity. The sale ends in 6 days. Now, you can still get this as of this upload, but I don't know when this is going to release. This may release soon. I don't know. So I may have talked about this in that vlog earlier, so you may have already known about this. But you can go to Stack Social. Matter of fact, guys, this said sale ends in 6 days the last time I checked it. So maybe it said 3 days. I don't know. Maybe they're extending it. Maybe it's just to get you to buy it. I don't know. But you can check it out. I got all these apps included in this bundle. And they're amazing. Okay, check out stacksocial.com. It comes with Snagit. That's this one right here. This one over here is called Mac X Video Converter Pro. It's also a screencast. I might try it next to see how it works, and you can convert videos. However, in my experience, what I used, it does not work half as good as Handbrake. It takes about twice as long to convert as Handbrake does. You also get something here called Boom for your Mac, and it will increase the volume of your speakers tenfold. I mean, you got small, dinky speakers, use this app, and it will blow it up, man. It sounds awesome. I mean, you got tons of volume. So that's enough for this time, guys. Thanks so much for watching. I believe I will get off here and leave you with an awesome picture. By the way, the last thing that I did, and I will show you this, just to get you an idea of what you would like to do. What I did is, if you wanted to do this, is I go to Y, or you can go to How. And a cool thing to do is, if you're on a Mac or, you know, Windows, whatever, take you a screenshot. So if I was on a Mac, I would push Command-Shift-4 and then just drag it, okay? I would just drag this across, and it would leave me a screenshot. Then I would find that screenshot, and I would actually enable that using my desktop background. So if I change my desktop background right now, I'll show you what I'm talking about. Right now, it's plain white. I just now switched to this, like, 2 or 3 hours ago, because I'm really getting into that nice clean look, and I want to experiment with this. I like the nice bright white look. You've probably seen me in some of my in my white hoodie. I really like that clean look that Apple has really developed, and now it's growing on me. So once this pops up, I'll show you what you can do to keep this on your mind. All right, so the screen right now is blank, as you can see, okay, and it's going to ask me about my desktop. Now if I go to wallpaper, I would locate, you know, first of all, you got to locate the picture that you just took, and most of the time it's going to appear on the desktop if it's a screenshot. So you go find it, and then you enable it as a wallpaper. Okay, and let me show you something cool that you can do with this, if it will show my pictures. All right, so I've got two of them. Actually, I've got the one, where'd it go to? I've got this one, now how it works, and I've got Why Pomodoro, okay? So I took a screenshot of it, and then I went ahead and then how it works was the other one. Took a screenshot, and then now it's available here. So if you want something to remind you of how good it is in your life, you do one. And if you want something that will remind you of how to do it, you do another. Okay, now we don't want to fit the screen. Obviously, it's not that big. You can go to fit the screen, or you can go to center, which will make it very small. You can go to stretch to fill the screen, which is too big. So I would just go fit the screen. But then you've got these black edges. What do? Well, as you can see, this is totally not totally white. So what I would do is I go to the color here. Click this color. Click your little magnification tool. And what it does is you put it on an area anywhere you want of that color. So I'm going to click on the color of the background here of this file, and bam, now it's pretty much seamless. You can barely see this line over here. So it looks very nice and, you know, sleek. And if it's not good enough, try another area. Try this area. See if it works. You know? But that's a pretty cool way to do it, so that you can always have it on your desktop. If you got two monitors, put this on your secondary monitor screen. Okay, but for now, I'm just going to stick with solid colors like I had before. So guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Please rate, subscribe, comment below, and let your friends know about these videos. Hopefully they will help them in their guitarpreneur life as well, and all the other videos that I have for guitar playing. Hopefully that will help as well. So thanks so much, guys. I'm going to tune out, and I'll see you guys in the next video. God bless.